Hey guys, what's up? Pase Bobby here. We are now in this last game for this November 15, 2022 NBA Game Day. So this is the battle between Brooklyn Nets with a record of 6 wins and 8 losses. Visiting Sacramento Kings with their record of 6 wins and 6. I couldn't see it. Yeah, 6 wins and 6. The game will be at 10 o'clock p.m. Eastern Time. So that's going to be 11 o'clock a.m. here in Manila. I'm just inviting everyone who have not subscribed yet to our YouTube account or YouTube channel, Pase Baller. Please click on the subscribe button below. At the same time, hit on that bell logo. That way, automatically, you guys will be receiving notifications whenever new videos are uploaded. All right. So, the spread given, by the way, is minus 1.5. And actually, that's given towards, is it the home team? Yep, that's given towards Sacramento Kings. So let's take a look at the standings of both teams. Brooklyn Nets, they belong to the Eastern Conference, and they are actually ranked number 12 at the moment with a record of 6 wins and 8. While Sacramento Kings, they belong to the West, and they are at number 9 with a record of 6 wins and 6. Sacramento Kings having the home court advantage on this. In terms of momentum, that's quite obvious. Sacramento Kings got it because Sacramento Kings, matter of fact, they are on a 3-game winning streak, man. That's quite a roll. while Brooklyn Nets, they're actually coming off that bad loss against the Lakers and Crypto.com Arena. Looking at the... hold on. I'm looking at the fatigue level of both teams. Well... both teams actually had their rest yesterday, so we can just skip that part. Both teams played the other night when Sacramento defeated Golden State and when Brooklyn lost to Los Angeles Lakers, so we can just skip that one. So I'm looking at the availability or the health for both teams. This is something that I've mentioned before, and again, I would like to give kudos and commendation to the assistant coaches of Sacramento Kings. Man, no one is actually listed in the injury list. No one is actually hurt. And perhaps that actually contributes a lot to their current success. Again, they are on a 3-game winning streak. While Brooklyn Nets, I see 5 names down here. Make that 6. Include Kyrie Irving suspension. TJ Warren is still out. While I see Yuta Watanabe, Ben Simmons, Seth Curry, and Nick Claxton listed as questionable for this particular game. All right. Whenever you got a team and you got Kevin Durant on it, you're always a competitor. You know, regardless whether there's Kyrie, regardless whether there's Seth Curry or what, Kevin Durant can really do it on his own. But it's gonna be tough, of course, and it's gonna be way easier for him if he would have his boys help him out. Now in this case, with those names being on the injury list, we ain't really sure how much help he would be getting, and if indeed he would be getting some help off the bench or maybe through the defense and all that. And just like what I said, Sacramento Kings, they are actually healthy. All of them are available. And for me, that contributes a lot to their current success. Now, their momentum, obviously, it's there. They are at home. The spread is just minus 1.5. I'm not really afraid whether KD would actually erupt with a 50-point game or what. I think Sacramento Kings can actually do a counter on its own, especially lately. The Aaron Fox is actually showing everyone and the entire world that he can do what he wants to do inside the basketball court. He is clutch. He can play defense. He can shoot it from the outside. And he's a dominant force whenever he takes it inside the paint. I'm quite confident on this. I'm gonna put my money on the Aaron Fox and his boys. Sacramento Kings covering the spread minus 1.5. Again, that's Sacramento minus 1.5. Peace out. Pase love and God bless.